Hey everyone, I am Vikram Salunke and welcome to x86 assembly. This is a video number 33 and in this video we will see sub, that is subtract instruction. This is a C program for sub instruction. First we are including stdio.h file. After that our main starts here. We have defined integer num1 equals 4, num2 equals 2 and another variable integer total. We are subtracting num2 from num1 and saving the result into the total, and finally we are returning that total. Okay, let's build the program. For that click on build, build solution. So build succeeded, and I have set some project properties for this program. If you want to know how to set the project properties, I'll give the video link in the I button above. Now let's debug the program. Before that, let's press a breakpoint here, click on debug, right click, go to disassembly. Okay, first instruction is push EBP. Currently EBP contains 0012FFB8, that is a old function stack frame pointer. We are pushing that onto the stack. Let's step into that. Okay, that got pushed onto the stack. After that we are moving ESP into the EBP to set up a main stack frame onto the stack. Let's step into that. Now as you can see, we are defining three variables, integer num1, num2 and total. So we need 12 bytes on stack to store those three variables. So that's why we are subtracting 0C in hexadecimal or 12 from ESP. Let's step into that. Okay, as we can see, we have subtracted 12 from the ESP. Now in the C program, we are defining integer num1 equals 4. So 4 will get moved into the address pointed by num1. Let's step into that. Okay, so 4 is onto the stack. Now we are defining second variable integer num2 equals 2. So 2 will get moved into the address pointed by pointer num2. Let's step into that. Okay, so 2 moved here. Now we are defining new variable integer total, and we are subtracting num2 from num1 and saving that result into the total. To do that, first compiler will move value pointed by pointer num1 into the EAX. Let's step into that. Okay, so now EAX contains 4. That is a value pointed by pointer num1. Now num2 will get subtracted from the EAX. So this is how the sub instruction will work. This is a source and this is a destination. So the value pointed by pointer num2 will get subtracted from the EAX. So that's how 2 will get subtracted from the 4 and the result will get saved into the EAX. Let's step into that. Okay, so 2 got subtracted from the 4 and the result is 2. That got stored into the EAX, as you can see here. Now that EAX will get moved into the address pointed by pointer total. Why? Because we are saving the result into the total. Let's step into that. Okay, so 2 got moved here. In the C code we are returning with the total, so the value pointed by pointer total will get moved into the EAX. Why? Because as we saw earlier, EAX contains the return value. Let's step into that. Okay, so EAX has 2 now. C program is ending here. So now it is a main's responsibility to clear the stack. How main can clear the stack? By pointing ESP to the EBP. For example, this is your EBP and this is your ESP, and these are the variables used by the main. So what compiler will do? It will point ESP to the EBP, and that's how automatically all those data will get clear. Let's step into that. Okay, as you can see, ESP is now pointing to the EBP. So main is ending here. So it is main's responsibility to give back the old function stack frame pointer back, that is on the top of the stack. Let's pop that into the EBP. That got done. And now using the return instruction, main will return to the old function, that is the initialization function who called main using the address from top of the stack, which is 0040128. Let's step into that. As you can see, main returned to the old function. Okay, so let's stop the debugging. So that's it for this video. I hope you understood the sub instruction. If you are still having trouble understanding the sub instruction, then please watch my next video. In that video, I will explain the same thing but an easy to understand animation format. And if you want to solve the exercises or read the text version of this video, then please visit the link from the description. Thank you.